Hello children, how are you all? Welcome to TenLearn. Today we will discuss lesson 2 of science class 6, that is components of food. Components of food. Food consists of different components or nutrients. Each food component is responsible for different functions in the body. Nutrients are substances needed by our body for proper growth and healthy body function. There are 7 main components of food that are carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, dietary fiber, and water. Carbohydrates. They are the primary energy source that our brain and muscles use. We need carbohydrates not only to support our growth but to also fuel our activities throughout the day. There are 2 major types of carbohydrates, that is sugar and starch. Sugar. Sugar is also called simple carbohydrate. Fruits, honey, milk, and table sugar are sources of sugar. Starch. Starch is called as complex carbohydrate. Plants stores energy in the form of starch. Cereals like rice, oat, wheat, and corn, potatoes, peas, and bread are sources of starch. When we eat plant products that contain sugar and starch, our digestive system breaks them into glucose. This glucose is the simplest form of sugar and is absorbed into the blood and provides us energy. Now we will see a simple test for starch, that is how we can find out that the food item contains starch or not. For that, take a small quantity of food item to be tested. Put 2 or 3 drops of iodine solution into it. Observe the color of the food item. Blue-black color indicates the presence of starch in the food item. Now we will see a simple test for sugar. First step is mix a small amount of each food sample with distilled water to make a test liquid. Then to a test tube, add 40 drops of liquid to be tested. If we are testing more than one liquid, then we have to label the test tube with a marker. Then add 10 drops of Bendix solution to each of the test tube. Carefully heat the test tube by suspending in a hot water bath at about 40 to 50 degrees Celsius for 5 minutes. Note any color change. If sugar is present in the solution, it will turn green, yellow, or brisk red depending on the concentration of sugar in the food item. You can see in the diagram the change of color according to the quantity of sugar. Fat. Fats are also great source of energy. Fats protect the internal organs. However, too much of fat can be damaging. Fat is also a great insulator. Fat stored just below the skin acts to insulate the body from cold. There are 2 types of fat, that is saturated fat and unsaturated fat. Some of the fat-rich foods are shown in the picture. Saturated fats are solid at room temperature, that is butter and ghee, whereas unsaturated fats are mostly liquid at room temperature, that is vegetable oils. Saturated fat can be found in beef, lamb, pork, butter, cream, milk, cheese, coconut oil, palm oil, and cocoa butter. Sources of unsaturated fats are fish, avocados, nuts and seeds, and plant-based products. Some of the food items having unsaturated fats, saturated fats, and trans fats are shown in the picture. Unsaturated fats are considered less damaging than saturated fats, and trans fats are considered very harmful for our health. Now we will see a test to find out fats in our food item. For that, take a small amount of food item to be tested. Wrap the food item in a piece of paper and crush it. Straighten the paper. Dry the paper by keeping in sunlight for a while. Observe the paper. An oily patch on the paper indicates the presence of fat in the tested food item. You can see in the picture, in one you can see a water drop and on the other side you can see a oil drop patch on a filter paper. Third is proteins. Proteins are needed by our body for muscle building and repairing worn out tissues. Our muscles, organs, and even blood are made up of mostly proteins. Proteins are needed to repair damaged cells and build new ones. They are important to build up our immune system. Both plants and animals are sources of proteins in our diet. Animal sources of protein are meat, fish, egg, and milk, and plant sources of proteins are pulses, soya beans, grams and nut. This picture shows some of the protein rich food items. Now we will see that how can we test for the presence of protein in our food item. Take a small quantity of food item to be tested. Grind, mash or powder the food item. Put the food item in a test tube. Add 10 drops of water and shake the test tube. Add 2 drops of copper sulfate solution in the test tube. Add 10 drops of caustic soda solution and shake the test tube. Observe the color of the mixture. Violet color indicates the presence of proteins in the food item. And if the color is still blue, that means the food item does not contain protein. Now we will discuss vitamins. Vitamins are needed for proper functioning of our body. They help in building up our immunity and protect us from various diseases and keep us healthy. There are 13 vitamins, each of which has specific functions. Vitamins are of two types, fat soluble and water soluble. Fat soluble vitamins. Vitamin A, D, E and K are fat soluble vitamins. These are stored in fat tissues of the body and are used when our body needs them. Our body prepares vitamin D in the presence of sunlight. Water soluble vitamins. Vitamins B1, B2, B3, B6, B12 and folic acid, together known as B complex vitamins, and vitamin C are water soluble vitamins. Since these vitamins are not stored in our body, therefore they must be regularly consumed by us. Food items such as citrus fruit, spinach and other fresh fruits and vegetables are good source of vitamin C. Lack of vitamins can cause deficiency disease in our body. The diagram shows two types of vitamin, water soluble and fat soluble, which are water soluble vitamins and which are fat soluble vitamins. The picture shows the sources of various vitamins. Vitamin A, the sources are egg, butter, papaya, carrot, milk, liver, cabbage, etc. Vitamin B sources are peas, meat, potatoes, soya beans, milk and whole grain cereals. Vitamin B2, green vegetables, custard apple, meat, cheese, soya bean, milk, etc. Vitamin B5, cheese, avocado, beef, white mushrooms, eggs and sunflower seeds. Vitamin B6 sources are dry fruits and nuts, peas, pulses, fish, meat and milk. Vitamin B7 are almonds, cauliflower, eggs, raspberries, bananas and walnuts. Vitamin B12 are eggs, meat, liver, cheese and milk. Vitamin C are guava, tomato, oranges, lemon, grapes and gooseberry. Vitamin D, egg, cod liver oil, milk, fish and sunlight. And sources of vitamin E are banana, green vegetables, soya beans, eggs, almonds and wheatgrass oil. Vitamin K sources are tomato, soya beans, spinach, meat, turnip and lettuce. Now we will discuss minerals. Minerals also help us to stay healthy. Minerals perform important functions such as formation of bones, teeth and blood cells and helps in maintaining the normal heartbeat. Minerals are of two types, macrominerals and trace minerals. Macrominerals are those that are needed in the body in large amount, example calcium, magnesium, sodium and potassium. And trace minerals or microminerals are those that are needed by our body in very small amount, for example iron, copper, zinc and iodine. This is the chart showing you macrominerals and microminerals. These are some of the food items containing various minerals. Now we will come on roughage and dietary fiber. The portion of plant food that remains undigested and do not provide any nutrients but provides bulk to our food is called roughage or dietary fiber. Roughage helps us in maintaining healthy digestive system. Roughages are of two types, soluble and insoluble. Soluble fibers are soluble in water, for example apple, strawberry, peach and rice. Insoluble fibers are not soluble in water. For example, whole grains, carrot, cabbage, turnip and cauliflower. Lack of insoluble fibers in the food can cause constipation. Vegetables, fruits, potatoes, breads, nuts and brown rice are some of the good sources of dietary fiber or roughage. The seventh essential component of our food is water. About 70% of our body weight is water. It is needed to keep us healthy. Water is needed to transport substances inside the body, to absorb nutrients from the food, to regulate our body temperature, for various chemical reactions such as digestive and excretion, which takes place in the body. We get water not only from the liquid we drink, but also from the food we eat. Milk, fruits, vegetables, and juices are good sources of water. We must drink at least 2 to 3 liters of water daily to keep our body healthy. Now, what is balanced diet? Balanced diet, a diet that contains adequate amount of different nutrients in right proportions along with roughage and water. A balanced diet must include food items from the following food group. First, milk group includes milk and milk products. Second is meat group includes meat, that is chicken, lamb, fish, etc. and meat substitutes, that is beans, peas, nuts and seeds. The third is fruit and vegetable group includes fruits and vegetables. And the fourth is grain group that includes breads and cereals. This is a picture that shows balanced diet plate of a non-vegetarian, and this is a picture that shows the balanced diet plate of a vegetarian. Now we will discuss the deficiency disease. Diseases that occur due to lack of nutrients over a long period of time are called deficiency disease or nutritional diseases. Deficiency of one or more nutrients can cause disease or disorder in our body. A nutritional deficiency occurs when a body doesn't absorb or get from the food the necessary amount of nutrients. Deficiencies can lead to a variety of health problems. These can include digestion problems, skin disorder, stunted and defective bone growth, and even dementia. Deficiency disease cannot be transmitted from one person to another. Deficiency of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are main source of energy. Deficiency of carbohydrates can lead to ketosis, that is excessive breakdown of proteins, fatigue, and decreased energy level and stamina, as well as reduced fiber intake. Deficiency of proteins. Human body need to consume a sufficient amount of protein on daily basis. Growing children need more proteins in their diet. Lacking of sufficient intake of proteins cause many health complications. Insufficient amount of protein may cause various health problems such as kwashiorkor, marasmus, impaired mental health, edema, organ failure, wasting and shrinkage of muscle tissues, and weakness of immune system. Kwashiorkor occurs in people who have a severe protein deficiency. Children who develop kwashiorkor are often older than the children who develop marasmus. Having a diet that's mainly carbohydrates can lead to this condition. Symptoms of kwashiorkor include edema or puffy or swollen appearance due to fluid retention, bulging of abdomen, and inability to grow and gain weight, skin disease, mental disease, and diarrhea. Marasmus occurs more often in young children or babies. It leads to dehydration and weight loss. Starvation is a form of this disorder. Symptoms of marasmus include weight loss, dehydration, chronic diarrhea, stomach shrinking, slow body growth, weak legs, poor muscle development, and mental retardation. The picture shows you two children, one having kwashiorkor and other is suffering from marasmus. Deficiency of vitamins. Vitamin A is a key for good vision, skin, hair, and healthy immune system and cell growth. Sources of vitamin A are cod liver oil, sweet potato, carrot, spinach, broccoli, mango, papaya, etc. Its deficiency causes night blindness. Symptoms of night blindness are dryness in eyes and improper vision. Vitamin B1. Vitamin B1 enables the body to use carbohydrates as energy. It is essential for glucose metabolism and it plays a key role in nerve, muscle, and heart functions. Its deficiency causes beriberi, that causes digestive problems, inflammation in nerves, and heart abnormalities. Sources of vitamin B1 are eggs, whole grain, nuts, oranges, and sprouts. Vitamin B2. Vitamin B2 can be found in grains, eggs, green leafy vegetables, and dairy products. It is crucial for breaking down food components, absorbing other nutrients, keeps skin and mouth healthy, and maintaining tissues. Its deficiency causes skin and intestinal disorders, irritation in eyes, and inflammation in tongue. Vitamin B12. plays an essential role in production of our red blood cells and DNA, as well as the proper functioning of our nerve system. Vitamin B12 is naturally found in animal foods, including meat, fish, poultry, egg, and dairy. Its deficiency causes anemia. Symptoms are pale skin, lack of stamina, and appetite, and frequent headaches. Vitamin C. Vitamin C is a powerful antioxidant that can strengthen your body's natural defenses, that is, boost the immune system, keeps teeth, gums, and bone healthy. Deficiency causes scurvy, that causes loosening of teeth, spongy, and bleeding gums. Increased susceptibility to disease, and slow healing of wounds, weakness, and pain in limbs. Main source of vitamin C are citrus fruits like lemon, oranges, tomatoes, red and green pepper, kiwi fruit, broccoli, strawberries, and sprouts. Vitamin D. Vitamin D is important for normal growth of bones in children and is important for overall immunity. Deficiency causes rickets, which results in weak bones, joints, and bone deformities, such as bow legs, pigeon chest, and softening of ribs and protruding abdomen. Main sources of vitamin D are milk, fish, egg, and sunlight. Vitamin K. Vitamin K helps in blood clotting, that is, stopping bleeding. Deficiency can lead to hemorrhage, that is, excessive bleeding. Main source of vitamin K are spinach, cabbage, and green leafy vegetables. Now we will discuss deficiency of some minerals. Calcium. Calcium strengthens bones, teeth, and health, including blood. Its deficiency causes osteoporosis in adults and rickets in children. Symptoms of calcium deficiency are brittle bones, excessive bleeding, and stunted growth, and weak teeth and bones. Sources of calcium are milk, green leafy vegetables. This picture shows some of the food that are rich in calcium. Phosphorus. Phosphorus strengthens bones and teeth. Deficiency leads to weakening of bones, poor development of bones and nervous system, mental retardation, retarded growth, and loss of weight. Its deficiency causes rickets in children. The main sources of phosphorus are cereals, pulses, and milk. Some of the food rich in phosphorus are seen in the picture. Iron. Iron helps in formation of hemoglobin and red blood cells. Deficiency leads to anemia. Symptoms are pale body color, fatigue, white nails, loss of weight, swelling in hands and feet. The main sources of iron are cereals, pulses, meat, green leafy vegetables. Some of the food items rich in iron are shown in the picture. Iodine. Iodine is required for proper working of thyroid gland. The body needs iodine to make thyroid hormones. The hormones controls the body's metabolism and many other important functions. Deficiency leads to enlargement of thyroid gland, mental retardation, and retarded growth. Deficiency disease is called goiter. Main sources of iodine are fish and salt. Some of the food rich in iodine are shown in the picture. Sodium and potassium helps in maintaining body water balance. Sources of potassium are most of the food items like vegetables, fruits, seafood, dairy products. Deficiency can lead to body and muscle weakness and dehydration, or can even cause paralysis. However, a person can get high blood pressure if he consumes too much of sodium and not enough potassium. Increasing potassium intake can reduce the risk of cardiovascular disease such as heart disease and stroke by lowering blood pressure. Some of the sodium rich food are shown in the picture, and some of the food rich in potassium are also shown in the picture. Magnesium. Its many functions include helping the muscles and nerve functions, regulating blood pressure, and supporting immune system. Sources of magnesium are nuts and seeds, dark green vegetables, whole grains, chicken, and fish. Deficiency leads to weak muscles and nerves. Symptoms are loss of appetite, sleeplessness, and upset stomach. Some of the food rich in magnesium are shown in the picture. Deficiency of water. Water is needed to help maintain a healthy weight, flush toxins from the body, and produce bodily fluids like saliva, etc. Water also contributes to regular bowel function, optimal muscle performance, and clear and youthful looking skin. However, failing to drink enough water can cause dehydration, adverse symptoms including fatigue, headache, weakness, weakened immunity, dizziness, and dry skin. Oral rehydrating solutions can be given to the patient to recover from dehydration or by consuming clear fluids such as water. Some dehydration patients, however, will require intravenous fluid in order to rehydrate. People who are dehydrated should avoid drinks containing caffeine such as coffee, tea, and sodas. So this was all about chapter 2. In the next video, we will discuss the question answers and book exercise of this chapter. Thank you.